Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm gonna show you how to resolve the requests to the server have been blocked by an extension error. The requests to the server have been blocked by an extension message is only for Chromium-based browsers. This means that Chrome, Chromium, Brave, Opera, Microsoft Edge, and other browsers could see this. In contrast, Safari, Firefox, and other non-Chromium browsers don't present this error. The number one reason the requests to the server have been blocked by an extension message occurs is ad blockers. Yet, several other kinds of extensions can also cause the error as well. Before we get into finding the cause of this error, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description, and remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's see if a browser extension is the cause of this error. It's always a good idea to make sure that the cause of an error is correct. In some cases, a system can deliver a false positive, so you should carry out a quick check. The best way to do this for the requests to the server have been blocked by an extension error is to open a private browser window. Because each browser is based on Chromium, the methods are the same in a broad sense. You'll access a private window through the right-hand menu option in browser. However, you might see different terms for the window depending on your browser. For example, Chrome calls it an incognito window. Microsoft Edge calls it an imprivate window. The Brave browser has two different private window options, either a standard one or a window using Tor for extra privacy. Choose the non-Tor private window and browse to the site you're having trouble with. If the error goes away, you'll know an extension is the cause of the error. As an aside, if you still see the error after using a private window, you may want to consider testing the issue in a different browser, on a different computer, and on lots of other websites. It could be that there's an issue on the server's end. Given the nature of this error, there's only one path to follow. You'll need to disable your extensions and recheck the website after each one to see which one is causing the message to appear. We're going to use Brave to illustrate this portion of the video, but the process will be very similar in other browsers. To start, you'll want to turn off your extensions. You can enter the extensions panel through either of two links on the right-hand side of the browser screen. If you choose the toolbar icon, this will show you a drop-down of your current extensions list. At the bottom, click the Manage Extensions link to get to the main management page. Once you're on this page, you can toggle each extension off using the red switch. Once you have a list of disabled extensions, you can begin to test them out. The process here is to toggle each one on an individual basis, then refresh the site to see if the error message has vanished. Our advice is to start with ad blockers and password managers. This is for a couple of reasons. Ad blockers are the primary cause of this error message, and password managers are also known to throw this error, especially if they let you autofill and populate login fields. Regardless, once you find the offending extension, you'll want to make a decision on how to proceed. First, you can go ahead and re-enable all of your other extensions, safe in the knowledge that you've identified the problematic one. Next, you'll want to consider the extension causing the issue. For now, keep this disabled and ask yourself, three questions. Do I need this type of extension for my browser? If so, is there anything I can do to resolve the issues this extension causes? And is there an alternative extension I can use to achieve the same functionality? It could be that you can change the settings for your extension, such as safe listing a particular site or network. It pays to visit the developer website and look for documentation. There may also be a known issue with the extension itself. For this, you'll want to again take a look at the developer's website for a hint. Reaching out to the developer can also be a good idea if the extension is vital to your workflow. Ask whether there's a fix for the issue you have and whether a patch is available. One extra option is to set up a new profile for your browser, as this will sometimes fix the error when nothing else has worked. There isn't a multiple profile setup for Brave, but you can reset your settings, which should achieve the same results. To do this, head to the settings page in your browser, scroll down the page, then choose the additional settings option. At the bottom of this section should be a way to reset your browser. It will have different options depending on your operating system. This is a little different from carrying out a cache clear, so be warned that you may lose your settings as a result. To create a new profile in other Chromium-based browsers, click the avatar icon in the toolbar. Then choose the Add option at the bottom. This will pop up a dialog box where you'll give the profile a name and choose a color scheme. Once you click Done, a new window will appear that's set to your new profile. From here, test out whether you still see the requests to the server have been blocked by an extension error on the site. An unsecured website puts your customers and reputation at risk. With Kinsta's Cloudflare integration, all the security features you need are built right into your plan at no additional cost. That's a monthly savings of around $200 per site. Learn more about these benefits, including DDoS protection, a more secure firewall, and more at kinsta.com/cloudflare-integration. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.